What's going on, everybody? It's that time where we talk about what our predictions are before the big boy live stream. Obviously, we're going to get the leaks, which if you can see on screen right now, this is from the last issue of Shonen Jump, which we will be having Bleach News. Now, it's a bit of a meme because they use Bleach News as BBS as well, Bleach Bro Souls. But I don't think this is the case, since as the live stream will be on Saturday and the magazine does come out on Monday for the Japanese. So, and we usually get leaks obviously quite early because whoever's doing the printing, whether it's in Japan or China, always seem to make sure to leak that shit. So anyway, let's get onto this, because I think we will be doing a video on Thursday when the leaks drop, of course, unless it's BBS related, which I highly doubt it will be. So we will be doing a video on that as soon as they drop, and that's going to be fun. And regardless of what the news is, whether we expect it or not, we're still going to live stream the live stream, because you never know what's exclusive to the live stream and what's exclusive to Jump Magazine. So let's get onto this. Of course, now I'm going to kind of somewhat contradict myself in this video, and this is what this video is kind of about, because in the last video that I made, I said that I don't think it's going to be a Bleach anime announcement, and I kind of want to expand on that a little bit more, because there was one thing I didn't take into consideration. So what is that thing? Well, I said that this is going to be mainly a Burn the Witch OVA live stream where they're going to be talking about Burn the Witch. There's also going to be other things about Burn the Witch that you guys are going to fox with, I hope, anyway. So look forward to that. We may talk about it on Thursday, obviously, if it gets announced, which I think it will because it's Jump Magazine. So hopefully that's a bit of a hint. But I said it's primarily going to be, half of it is going to be a commemoration, with the other half going to be mainly Burn the Witch, right? The one thing I didn't actually take into consideration, which I had a live stream with my boy Clyde. So if you know Clyde, go subscribe to him and go follow him. There is one thing I didn't take into consideration, which was it does specifically say Bleach Project, and which I keep saying this and I keep changing my mind, but there's Bleach Project and there's other works from Kubo, right? So the other works from Kubo is Burn the Witch, right? That's what it is, right? The Bleach Project, why on earth was it in my head that it's not going to be Bleach related when it says they're going to announce a Bleach Project? So that means a project is, well, it's a project, it's a product, it's a service, it's something, right? So regardless of what it is, regardless of what this live stream is, which is primarily going to be Burn, which I think, you know, and I did say in the last video, I do feel like they'd acknowledge it, even though I know what I know, which is a guaranteed Burn the Witch. The thing is that I tried to express in the last video is, because I know the end game of everything, I just don't know how it's going to be presented. And seeing as this is going to be one of many Bleach events, because it literally says within the Shonen Jump live stream that it is a first glimpse, means that, you know, this is going to be a year-long campaign, just like the I'm Still Bleach campaign, which ran for about 6 months. At first, again, we had the live-action movie, then the Burn the Witch one-shot, and then following up with the Bleach Jet art book. That was a six-month campaign, and it, obviously, I did a video on that explaining how much a good idea, a good estimate, it's nowhere near, because obviously there's a lot of numbers which haven't been made public, but we have a good idea of how much was spent on the campaign, and obviously did well. We're talking way over the six million mark on advertising alone on one singular thing. So it was a lot of money went into these campaigns, and obviously it's done well enough to advocate more campaigning for Bleach. As I said, this seems to be like it's going to be a year-long campaign, scenes as like the anniversary for Bleach isn't actually until next year, being the 20th anniversary on the 2021, around about August, I believe it is. So it's a bit weird that they do it a year earlier in advance. Anyway, enough with the word filler, there's going to be more events to this. So that's why I was thinking, okay, they're going to test the waters, they're going to do Burn the Witch a little bit, they're going to keep the Bleach fandom a bit hype, and then towards around the end game, they're going to be like, bam, Bleach anime. But hypothetically, they could do it later on within the campaign and be like, here's the Bleach PV. So I feel like it can be announced in this one, because when you look at, okay, well, they're definitely releasing a Bleach project here. Like, it literally says Bleach project and other works. So the other works is Burn the Witch. What is this Bleach project? What is this product service, right? Because that's what a project is. We've already discussed that it can't be a live action movie because it's a bit weird that the voice actors would be there. I don't actually think they're going to commemorate it. Maybe they'll talk about their time with Bleach, but I don't think they're going to show anime clips, because that might be a bit weird with the rights holding right now. So again, maybe commemoration, maybe not. So again, why would the voice actors be there? A mobile game, the voice actors aren't going to be there. If they want to be somewhere, they're going to be for the BBS live stream. So that's where they would be for that. They're not going to be there to announce manga, because again, what would voice actors have relevant to a manga? What would they have relevant to a game? What relevancy would they have for a live action movie? It has to, again, as I said, it's the idea or the theory of elimination, where you have to kind of condense it to what the voice actors are relevant in. And this all kind of boils down to anime. And again, the reason why I'm very doubtful about that is because I only know of the one thing, and it's a year-long project, advert campaign. So it's not that I'm lying by any sense of the imagination. It's more so the idea of, I know it's coming, like that's the end game of it all. It seems a bit too soon, but they can announce or acknowledge that it is coming back. And I feel like that may be the case here. Pretty much this video is just to express any questions, hence why I'm doing the live stream at the same time, any questions or any other thing that people are kind of doubting right now. I will just say, the number 6 is very important, Grimmjow Jaggerjack, so I'll leave that with that. So I'm just going to give a quick predictions on what I think this year campaign is going to be surrounded about, and why I think they're going to do this kind of method at the moment. So I would imagine, right, I would imagine if they were to bring the Bleach market back, which it's been almost 10 years since the ending of the first anime, I would imagine is that they want a new audience. I mean, we've seen from the last campaigns and like the Bleach Jet art book and whatnot, they already has a solidified fan base to garner the fact that Bleach can self-sustain itself, right? So I think Shueisha's going this route of being like, well, we want a new audience. And I think what they're doing is they're slowly bringing in a new audience by first saying, okay, here's Burn the Witch, right? Here's this OVA. You might get more content in the future about Burn the Witch. If it does well, you might get an anime from it. You know, that's the realm of possibility. I think like this is kind of that teaser into getting people interested, getting people talking about Bleach again, and then you go off the momentum. As soon as the momentum's there, then you can start dropping more and more news and building up the hype. This is all about building up hype. And we've seen this with the Iron Bleach campaign, which we will talk about the campaigns later. But for now, I feel like Burn the Witch is that lovely little new thing that no one's really experienced. It's within the Bleach world, and it will pique curiosity of the readers. They'll want to know more about Bleach, and they'll probably go buy the volumes because they've been like, oh, well, this world is surrounded about Soul Society, and I want to know about the original story. So that's why I kind of question whether it's a sequel / spin-off. I don't know what kind of category to put it in, but nonetheless, I think this is smart for them to say, Burn the Witch first, get the new audience in while pleasing the old audience. So both the old audience and the new audience get something new. We can talk about it, make more content, make more articles. There's more news channels about it. See what the overall demand is. And then once you've kind of garnered that and you've got a bit of momentum, then you can then start dropping the Bleach news, because not only have all these new people that have just gone and bought the manga for Bleach, but now they're going to be excited for when the anime drops. So I feel like that's the position that they're going for at this current moment in time. Now, to talk about the Bleach campaigns and advertisements in general, this is where we also go back into the idea of theory of elimination, is that the only real thing that we've seen for promotion-wise this big, we're talking like, you know, this is pretty big, like Anime Japan and obviously a new website. The only close thing we got to this was like an Instagram account where it kind of countdowned, and we got the Burn the Witch and the, not so much the live action movie, but the Bleach Jet art book, right? That was a countdown. And I'd say that was pretty significant, to be honest with you. It was a pretty expensive product. It was a very high quality product, and they wanted it to sell. We can use that as like an idea of how they're going to use this advertising to promote something. But there has not been a singular mobile game that has ever been pushed like this, okay? And it clearly says at the bottom of the website, Shueisha / Kubo. So this is definitely just in regards to them, right? So the mobile games, PlayStation games, it's completely irrelevant, because if you look at every other game, I mean, look at Kimetsu no Yaiba. Why hasn't that just recently got a PlayStation 4 announcement? Why has that not got its own website? That was it didn't even get an Anime Japan thing. The Anime Japan thing was about like the movie that's coming out, but that wasn't even like its own stage. That was more like an Aniplex lineup stage that they were going to do, so it wasn't going to be its own entity. So even for Kimetsu no Yaiba, which is the biggest, one of the biggest things in Japan right now, literally competing with One Piece, they don't even have their own dedicated countdown website, nor did it have their own specific stage. So we can literally say mobile games, PlayStation games, completely out the water on this one. We can cross that off. Manga, it's a possibility. Usually manga, they get kind of shouted out in the magazine. Obviously, we can see the scan here, but this is obviously for the announcement of, like, the announcements in the live stream. The closest thing we got to this was with Dragon Ball Super and Masashi Kishimoto, right? Where they had Jump Festa announcements at their own specific stage, right? But they didn't have, like, a website or anything. So, like, that you can argue a new manga, which is, I think, is fantastic as well. I do, which I think is pretty epic. So it's going to be at least relevant. It's going to be at least something, you know, not disappointing for fans. Live action movie. I don't think a live action movie would have been announced at Anime Japan, you know, it's a bit weird, you know, Anime Japan to have a live action announcement or a game announcement or a manga announcement and not have a anime announcement at Anime Japan. The anime obviously is Burn the Witch, right, which is solidified. Point of the matter is, if anyone's going to promote it, it's either going to be Jump in their, obviously, their advertisement page, and Warner Brothers, who have the rights to it. So Warner Brothers would promote it on their Twitter. Jump will probably promote it on their Twitter and whatnot. There wouldn't be a separate entity website, especially for a countdown, man. And it's not going to be something silly like Sakura Wars, which I've seen a few memes about, so there you go. So if we look at past campaigns, no campaign at the moment has been this big to this regard. And again, like a 6 month I'm Still Bleach campaign in comparison to now a year long, Face Again campaign, whatever you want to call it, is a bit, it's a bit more than just basically whatever we had for the I'm Still Bleach is a level up from that. And we were pretty fucking convinced about I'm Still Bleach. We were pretty convinced about, like, what was going to be announced there. But obviously, we've pretty much had everything except for the pachinko machine. But I don't think we're going to get a pachinko machine. Another big question that people also have is, why is it an OVA? Like, why is it confirmed to be an OVA and not an anime series? So this is actually a pretty logical question that may actually wrap a few people's heads. So I've got the answer for that. Unfortunately, or fortunately, I don't know, because of the Olympics, most TV stations will actually be, well, showing the Olympics. It's a big national thing to show. And not many shows will either not happen or get pushed back a few seasons until the Olympics is over. So obviously they have a time slot, because the majority of time slots have been taken because of the Olympics, running on multiple TV stations. So that's pretty much why you get an OVAs, whether it be a theatrical release or maybe a TV time slot, depending on the time. It's not really completely fleshed out on what's going on in that situation, but those are the two possibilities at the moment. It goes to show that, like, yes, like, maybe we'll get an edited version of Burn the Witch later on as a series. But for now, it's an OVA because, again, they can't really put it on TV because there's not really any time slots because of the Olympics. So that's kind of why we've got an OVA route at this current moment in time. Also, there were some quick questions about the shout about Anime Japan's announces really becoming on, I think it was Alama TV or something like that. It's basically going to be on Japanese TV. A lot of the announcements that was going to be happening at Anime Japan 2020 and now actually going to be announced on TV, which there is a time schedule. There will be a link in the description down below so you can check out the time schedule. There isn't anything specific to Bleach, so to say, which is very interesting because I think, you know, Shueisha are going to have a little involvement within that TV time slot as a whole. I think it's going to be running for like 48 hours. They're going to be rerunning some like old episodes of some shows such as like ReZero and whatnot, like shows that are like still relevant that are getting like season twos and whatnot. The point is of what I'm saying is about this and why I'm going to say, oh, you're probably going to get not only a Burn the Witch PV or trailer or whatnot at the Bleach event, but you're also going to have it on TV, is because obviously I think that's a good marketing move for Shueisha. But I think the reason why this is happening on TV is because many companies have so many different series that they can't specifically make one event for it. So, I mean, look at Kimetsu no Yaiba, for example. Like, they really, like, are making it their own fucking event here, right? So the fact that like a bunch of companies are putting it on TV, it probably helps them budget wise from the losses that they would have made from Anime Japan. The point of what I'm trying to make is in one of these TV time slots, obviously there's a bunch of animes that are going to get announced, which is cool. But there's also, I think, 4 time slots where it specifically says Aniplex's new 2020 lineups. So I would imagine like that's a segment where they just shoot the shit of like how many like anime series that Aniplex has that are going to be coming out in 2020. So you probably will be getting Burn the Witch among those many titles that Aniplex has. So this is Shueisha's, because Aniplex haven't got their own live stream. So this is Shueisha's marketing for Bleach, which I think is awesome. And then you also have Aniplex doing their thing for TV. So just wanted to talk about that. That's very interesting. I don't think the Aniplex thing, I know for a fact the Aniplex thing on TV isn't going to be for Bleach. It's going to be for Burn the Witch, showing the trailer for that. Expect something really awesome with that. Maybe they will show a little teaser for Bleach. Maybe like how they did with that Ichigo. You know, the one that we showed, the Bleachy Anime Japan 2020, you know, something like that. But they won't show a PV or anything like that. They'll probably just like show maybe some anime clips of it and then say, oh, look, here's Burn the Witch. Maybe, I don't know. But that's going to be interesting as well, and I'm going to be keeping my eye out on that as well. That will be happening on the 21st, so the same day that the Bleach livestream does kick off. So a lot of things to talk about. And I think that's pretty much the majority of like the generalization about this whole prediction, speculation, whatever you want to call it, because we don't truly know what's going on with the whole Bleach thing right now, because that has been very much lock and key to specifically Shueisha, Kubo, and Aniplex. I'm not saying that like obviously Bleach cannot be announced, because it can, it simply can. It's just like for me, the reason why I said what I said in previous videos is because like I only know of one thing, right? And because this is again a year-long campaign, I wouldn't assume that they're going to throw all their eggs in one basket, but we are going to find out very soon. Hopefully I've tried my best to explain everything in this current situation. The Burn the Witch anime is happening because I've seen it. I haven't seen the anime, but I've seen evidence of it. I've seen actually quite a lot of it. So, you know, that's happening. And I think it's very important, as I've said time and time again, if you want Bleach to come back, right, then you've got to support Burn the Witch. That's just as simple as it is. There's no question about it, because it gives Shueisha a good idea about how much time and effort they put into the franchise, so to say. So, again, this whole website, very interesting. We're getting a product of Bleach. We're getting a project of Bleach, regardless of what it is. We have Bleach news. We have Burn the Witch news. So we have 2 amazing news to talk about when it happens. We've solidified that it's not a game. We've solidified that it's possibly a manga because of the nature of how it is at the moment. That's a possibility. But again, that's more so, you know, other works. For Bleach specifically, we know that it's not a live action. We know that it's not a mobile game. We know that it's not a PS4 game. And it's definitely not a fucking pachinko machine. So, or an art book or anything like that. We know that it's going to be relevant because of previous events. So the only thing at the moment we can really clarify it to, the one thing that it really points to, is an anime. And unless somebody in the comment section can give me a good valid reason as to why voice actors being there would be relevant to promoting a Bleach product other than anything that they're involved in, then shoot it in the comment section down below. Other than that, it looks like, to me, we're getting a Burn the Witch OVA with some extra little tidbits, and we're getting something Bleach motion related. So it's going to be a very exciting time. Anyway, we've only got 2 more days until the leaks come out, and only a few more days until the live stream. So please click on that subscribe and hit the bell so you can join the live stream when we have our little celebration and keep up on the latest news and whatnot. Other than that, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers out. You guys, of course, have this fine David Hansen. And as always, people, peace out.